Hello students, how are you all? Hope all are you better and doing your study well. Last time we have been discussed about the cyclotron, and today we are going to start our next topic, that is Biot-Savart's law. As you know, here Biot and Savart are the name of two scientists who derived the value of a magnetic field intensity dB due to a small current carrying element dl. Here a current carrying wire is shown, and dl is the length element of it, and we have to determine the value of a magnetic field intensity due at a distance r. You can see R at point P, and here DL is the small length element. This is DL, length, small length element, and the wire have current I, and theta will be angle between the DL and R. Now according to Biot-Savart, the value of magnetic field intensity due to this small length element DL will be directly proportional to the current flowing through it, and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the point P and the length element dl, and also directly proportional to the dl sine theta. Dl is the length element, and theta is, you can see from here, theta is the angle between the r and dl. So dB is directly proportional to the dl sine theta. Now on combining all these three equations 1, 2 and 3, dB must be equal to, or dB must be directly proportional to I dl sine theta by r square. Whenever we remove the sign of a proportionality from here, then a constant will be put it here, and that constant is called, it is mu naught over 4 pi. It is given here. Here the sign of proportionality is mu naught over 4 pi, you can see, and the value of mu naught over 4 pi is 10 raised to power minus 7, and it is a constant of proportionality. And here mu naught is the absolute permittivity of a free space or vacuum. Here mu naught is the absolute permittivity of free space, and you can derive the units for mu naught. Its units will be Tesla per ampere meter. You can derive from the given formula, as you can see from here. Here magnetic field is in Tesla, current is in ampere, and length is in meter, and r square will be in meter square, and sine theta is a constant value, and mu naught over 4 pi is also constant, and we have to determine mu naught. B is Tesla here, and I is ampere. Whenever I goes to the right left hand side, it will become ampere inverse, and here ampere meter cancel out by the meter square, and 1 by m will left, and after the cross multiplying we will get Tesla per ampere meter. So this is the value of a magnetic field. So these are the unit of a absolute permittivity of a free space. Now we can write in vector form. dB in vector form can be written as, because dB is equal to mu naught over 4 pi ideal sine theta by r square. And here we know theta is the angle between the length element dl and the r. So we will have to multiply and divide by r here. And after multiplying and dividing by r, we will get, and then in vector form it can be written as. So this is the vector form of our Biot-Savart's law. Now the next, the application of a Biot-Savart's law. Biot-Savart's law have three applications, and we are going to discuss about the one application of it in this video lecture. So here the first application is the magnetic field intensity due to a current carrying circular coil. Here a current carrying circular coil is shown. You can see the current flowing through it is I, and R is the radius of the circular coil, and I is the value of the current which is flowing through the coil. And we have been considered here a length element DL, and we know the length element DL acting along the tangent of the circle, and tangent of the circle is always perpendicular to the radius, and therefore theta will be 90 here. So according to Biot-Savart's law, the value of magnetic field intensity due to this length element DL at the center of circular coil will be dB is equal to mu naught over 4 pi I DL sin theta divided by R square, and theta is 90 here. You can see theta is 90 here, and that's why the value of magnetic field intensity dB become 4 pi I DL by R square. This is the small value of magnetic field intensity due to the length element, but we have to determine the magnetic field intensity due to the complete coil. So after integrating, the integration of dB become capital B, and here mu naught over 4 pi and the current I and the radius of the circle R are constant, radius of the coil R are constant, so only DL is the variable, and DL is the length element on the circular coil. You can see from here, and after integrating it will become the whole length become equal to the circumference of the circle. So the integration of DL will be 2 pi R. You can see from here, this is the circumference of the circle, and here pi is cancelled out by the pi, 2 is cancelled out by the 4, and after simplifying we will get mu naught I divided by 2R. So this is the magnetic field intensity due to the circular loop at the center of a coil. But our coil consists of a n number of turns, and this is the value of magnetic field intensity due to the one single circular loop, and therefore the net magnetic field intensity due to the whole coil which consists of a capital N number of turns will be this much, which means it is multiplied by the capital N, which is the number of turns in the magnetic in the coil. So net magnetic field intensity at the center of a coil will be given as N mu naught I over 2 R. Thank you.